For almost 50 years, our next group, Sesame Workshop, has been educating and preparing young minds for an easier social and academic transition to the early years of school. For years, whenever I visit my friends along Sesame Street, they always share helpful information on numbers and counting, letters and reading, friendships, and even some science. Lately, my friends from Sesame Street have helped me to better understand some of the big issues inside the little heads of my youngest friends. Some kids have deep concerns about daily frustrations, the loss of a loved one, divorce, and their parents, even how to prepare for new situations, like going to school for the first time. Today, I'm very happy to have with us two of my really good friends from Sesame Street, Chris Knowings, and the one and only Elmo, preparing to start preschool next week. Hey, Elmo, how's it going today?
Hey.
Hi, Chris.
Yeah, hey, buddy. By the way, yeah, he's the one starting preschool, not me, so just saying. Hey, buddy, what are you up to?
Oh, boy. Well, you see, Elmo's first day of preschool is today.
Okay.
And Elmo's, well, Elmo's a little bit nervous.
Oh, okay.
So Elmo's bringing a lot of things from home to make him feel more comfortable.
Okay.
So he's made a list of all those things.
Oh, okay. Well, it's good to be prepared, so what'd you pack?
Okay, let's see. Crayons.
Okay, check.
Very important. Mm-hmm. Watercolors.
Ah, check, check.
Uh-huh. Elmo's lunchbox.
Uh-huh, well, gotta have one of those.
Instruction paper.
I think preschool
has good... Elmo's toothbrush. Elmo's favorite bedtime story.
All right.
Cheese and crackers. Okay. An umbrella, a scarf, a jigsaw puzzle.
Elmo? Huh? Slow down, buddy. What? Slow down.
Oh, there's a picnic basket, too. Elmo forgot the picnic basket.
Okay.
Uh-huh. Oh, and Elmo's still trying to figure out where to put Dorothy in the bed.
Dorothy? Whoa, 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 whoa. Your pet goldfish?
Uh-huh.
Elmo, time out, man.
What?
Don't you think that's a bit much? I mean, that's a lot of things we're bringing to school, man.
Really?
Yeah, yeah. I mean, you're only in school for part of the day, but it sounds like you're packing your whole bedroom.
Well, yeah, but what if Elmo wants to play with Dorothy during school?
Elmo, I'll tell you what. I can promise you, Dorothy and everything else you own will be at home when you get there, okay?
Well, yeah, but, well, okay.
Buddy, you're a little bit scared, aren't you? A little scared?
A little bit.
A little bit?
Yeah.
Can I tell you something?
What?
I was a little scared the first time I went to school, too.
What? Really?
Yeah.
Get out of town.
Yeah. I will not get out. I'll tell you right here. I'll tell you, when I first went to school, I was super scared, just like you. But it's okay to be scared. But I will tell you something about school.
Yeah?
It's pretty awesome.
Oh, really?
Yeah, yeah. You get to have a lot of fun. You get to make new friends.
Uh-huh.
And since you're already great when it comes to sharing and playing with others, you get to share and play with your new school friends.
Cool.
Yeah. So you get to learn new things.
And play games,
mm-hmm.
Right?
Yes, absolutely.
Oh, boy. And then maybe after school, Elmo could come to Hooper's and tell Chris all about his day.
You absolutely can. And listen, if you have any questions, any issues, anything at all, my door is always open. You always come to me.
Well, thank you, Chris.
Hey, I'll tell you what. Why don't we open up that bag of yours?
Oh, do you want to help Elmo unpack all his stuff?
No. See, I was thinking we could go for that picnic basket. I'm hungry.
That's a better idea.
Hey, do you guys have any...
You like pickles.
You have any fruit in there that maybe you could share? Is there enough for all of us?
Yeah, sure. You want an apple? Elmo's got an apple,
got
a carrot, a banana.
Yeah? Any grapes?
No grapes. Elmo's got a cabbage.
You know, Elmo, I remember the first day that I went to school, it was I was a little nervous, too. Actually, all right, let's say I was a lot nervous. And it's really not that bad. It's actually really fun. Yeah.
Oh, cool.
Yeah, I mean, you get to, as he was saying, you get to make new friends. You like new friends, right?
That's true.
Yeah, and so, and every time, for example, when you go to Hooper's store, you get new ideas about new stuff. Well, school's even cooler than that.
Oh, cool.
Yeah.
I was excited.
Yeah. So Chris, were you nervous when you went to school? Are there other times in your life when you were nervous?
Absolutely. The first day of school, the day I graduated school, because, you know, I'm wondering what's going to be the next thing in my life.
Yeah.
But after I graduated school, it turned out to be great because I got to meet my buddy here. I got a great job working at Hooper's, made a lot of friends. So school was nervous, but it was worth it because I had a great time.
So Elmo, do you remember the first day when you met Chris?
Oh, yeah. Elmo remembers it like it was yesterday.
Oh, yeah. Wait, hold on. Was that the time I had chickens thrown at me? No. Wait, was
that
it
was
pie?
The second. That was the second time.
Second time? Okay, was there a pie? No.
It was probably a pie.
Yeah. It was a lot. I know every time.
There was a lot going on that day.
Yeah.
You know, well, I asked that because now, look at you. You guys are such good friends, right?
Absolutely.
Right? So when you go to school, you might be a little nervous on the first day when you meet someone new, but then afterwards, they might become a really good friend like Chris is.
Oh, that's true. Yeah, that makes a lot of sense.
Doesn't it, though? I like that.
Yeah, you know, I used to love to go ahead and finger paint and, you know, kind of, you can have play time and you can actually get a little dirty as long as your teachers approve and you can eat all kinds of food as long as it's good, right? So it's actually pretty fun. It's a way to get away from your parents for a little while when they're not looking and you can actually have nice play time with lots of new friends.
Oh, cool. Elmo can't wait to meet lots of new friends.
Can you finger paint?
Elmo can finger paint.
I can't finger paint.
I want to toe paint.
That's good.
How many finger how many fingers do you use when you paint?
We almost only got four fingers. I was still waiting for the fifth one to grow in.
It's okay. Four's cool. Four's so cool. Don't worry about it.
So, you know, what's your school like, by the way?
We're almost not sure. I almost not been there yet.
Right.
Today's the first day. I'm hopes it's lots of fun.
Yeah. Have you guys seen it? Chris, have you seen it?
I've seen it. Actually, I know some people that went there. He's
really?
Going to have a great time. Yeah. You don't have Dorothy to take with you, but they have their own fish tank, and you get
cool.
to see new fish. There are games.
Yeah.
There are books to read.
Uh-huh.
You're
going
to have lots of fun, man. I think there's even like instruments for, you know, playing music. You like music, right?
Elmo plays the violin.
Elmo can also
I
sing.
I didn't know that.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, so
See, I just got
well, you're
started.
Just off Broadway, so this is really the...
That's
oh,
right.
yeah.
This is your debut.
Uh-huh. We gotta go to the New Amsterdam.
Can you get us tickets? Do you know a guy?
Oh, Elmo could get us in.
That's what I'm talking about.
All right, so listen, I hope that you're a little less nervous about going to school.
Elmo feels much better now. Thank
yeah?
you.
Yeah, and you don't need all that stuff in the backpack. Really, you're the most important part of the school.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, cool.
The food's great. Well, the food's great if you bring it.
Yeah.
And the food's depends. If you really like something special, you should.
Oh, Elmo's got lots of food here.
Yeah.
Got some coleslaw.
Whoa.
Uh-huh.
You brought cabbage with you.
Yeah, that's not gonna
cabbage
that's
to
not
school.
That's gonna spoil.
Yeah, that's good. I'll
yeah.
take
oh,
that.
Boy, that was not a good idea.
Yeah. All right, you don't need to take all the stuff in your room. That's
okay.
all I'm saying. Okay, well, listen, I know you guys have to get going, but
oh, yeah.
we'll catch up in a little bit. Thank you so much for stopping
thank
by.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay. All right, I've got a good feeling about Elmo making it through the rest of the day.
During this hour, we've been talking about the huge impact early education has on children's lives. I'm William Brangham. Education initiatives have been a part of Channel 13 since its beginning over 50 years ago. Sesame Street has been doing this same kind of community outreach since the organization began 45 years ago. WNET and Sesame Workshops have teamed up to bring the Little Children Big Challenges program to the Mott Haven Library in the Bronx, in one of the poorest congressional districts in the country. This program teaches parents to reinforce their children's grit and encourage kids to persevere through life's everyday challenges. I'm joined today by some of early education's finest. Lynn Chwatsky, Vice President of Initiatives and Partnerships for Community Engagement at Sesame Workshop, Kim Mullaney, Director of Education at WNET, and mother of three and workshop participant, Anabel Andon. Let's take a quick look at one of Sesame Workshop's Little Children Big Challenges videos.
Boy, I'm just so
frustrated.
Yes. Yes, Elmo is very frustrated because Elmo can't do buttons.
Well, yet.
What's that?
You can't do the buttons yet, but one day you will.
No, Elmo will never be able to.
Oh, son, I know it feels that way, but that's because you're so frustrated. You gotta keep trying and not give up.
What a sweet clip. Lynn, we can see in this video that resilience is something that the Sesame Workshops focuses on. What kinds of issues are related to resilience that come up in these workshops?
Well, the truth is resilience and helping children persevere and get through the little challenges that they experience every day and sometimes even the big challenges is part of Sesame Workshop and part of Sesame Street and what we have done for, truthfully, over 45 years. And what we've done through these workshops is really taken this concept and these skills and help children understand that even when they are presented with some of these challenges, they could use the skills that we're giving them to get through them.
This particular program at Mott Haven Library, what was the specific goal of that workshop?
So the goal was to really empower parents and providers in the community with these tools.
There are many different challenges, and when we use those challenges to establish resilience, they can really help our children develop important skills.
Okay? Kim, what happens to kids at a young age if they start to fall behind?
It's very hard for them to catch up. So if children are not able to keep up with their peers in terms of reading, by the time they get to the end of third grade, if they're not reading on grade level, that's a big indicator for trouble in the years ahead.
Why is it important for public stations to get involved in their communities in this way?
We are a voice for the community, and we want to support our viewers, the people that we work with, the people that we live with. And that means acting as a concerned citizenry to make sure that we're supporting our youngest learners in any way that we can.
Anabel, welcome.
Thank you.
You've mentioned that your daughter Jezebel was one of the ones who you felt like you could really use some specific help with. Tell me what was going on with Jezebel.
Her thing was anger and lashing out. We're still working on it. It's different from when we first started this workshop.
Is there one specific thing that you can remember, a particular technique or tool that she learned in this workshop?
To stop, think, and action.
When I have a problem, I have feelings too, but I'm happy I can solve it when I breathe, think, do. When I breathe, think, do.
Yay! Yay, very good!
For example, we just moved. We used to live with her grandmother, and she's so attached to her. And she will just start crying, and I'm like, okay, let's do the breathing. And then she'll explain to me, what is she feeling? I'm happy that I had this workshop, because I don't know about what I've done.
Lynn, you've been doing this for, I think, almost 15 years now. Is there a specific moment that stands out for you?
Once I was in Chicago, and I was doing a presentation for children and families whose parents have died in the war in Iraq, Afghanistan. And there was one child who was inconsolable in the audience, completely inconsolable. And so we continued. I did my part, Elmo did his part. And at the end, I sort of made eyes with the child's grandma who he was with. And she came up to me and she apologized to me. And I said, oh, please don't, please, there's no reason to apologize. You know, it's okay. And she looked at me and she said, can I hug you? And I said, of course you can hug me. And she said, thank you. She starts hysterically crying. And I said, you're so welcome. It's an honor to be here. And she said, no, you don't understand. His dad died 6 months ago, and this is the first time he's expressed any emotion since his dad died. You have given us the gift, and hopefully now he'll actually be able to talk about how he's feeling and his emotions. So those are the times where I, again, have the tears, and I feel like this work is so important and so meaningful.
That's got to give you a great, great sense of strength in doing this kind of work. Thank you. And thank you all very, very much for being here. Sesame and WNET have a long history of working together to make a difference in children's lives. The kids they work with are set on a positive path early on, and their futures are looking bright. Coming up next, we'll meet some adults who are supporting students by sticking with them for years and years. Visit AmericanGraduate.org and tell us how you plan to help in your community.
American Graduate Day, a live nationwide outreach event.
We want to hand it off now to Lauren Wanko, who's out on the street with Sesame Street cast members Chris Knowings and Elmo. Hey, Lauren.
Hi, we are having a great time here. I love my friends from Sesame Street. Hi, Elmo. How are you today?
Good, thanks. How are you?
Are you having a good time on our outdoor set here?
Oh, it's great. Elmo loves it.
You do?
Uh-huh.
Now, we heard all about your adventures leading up to preschool, but tell me, what did you already learn from all the great adults on Sesame Street?
Oh, boy. Well, you know, Chris helps Elmo a lot.
Oh, yeah.
And whenever Elmo has a question, he asked Chris, or his mommy, or his daddy.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and they help Elmo a lot.
They do.
Now, Chris, do you help Elmo with his ABCs, with counting?
ABCs, counting. We learned how to ride a bike together.
Oh, that's right.
Got the helmet all right, the knee pads.
Uh-huh.
Oh, yeah, you rode it on your own, too.
Yeah, baby.
Did you fall down at all, Elmo?
Yeah, a little bit.
A little bit? Any scratches or bruises?
Just a little boo-boo on his knee.
But did you get, oh.
That's fine. That's
did
fine.
It heal?
Don't pity Elmo.
But did he get back out on the bike?
Oh, he got right back up and he had a great time, too.
That's cool.
So now, Chris, we're talking a lot with our viewers about their American Graduate Champion.
Oh.
And I want to know, who's your champion?
Oh, that's easy.
What do you think, Elmo? You want to know that, too?
Elmo wants to know.
Okay, so let's hear it.
There's a hard-hitting interview.
It's definitely my mom.
We might not have enough confidence.
It's my mom. My mom was my 8th grade history teacher.
Aww.
Not far from here, right down the street from here. So
hi, Chris's
best
mom.
Teacher I ever had. Hi, Mom.
Say hi, Mom.
I've always wanted to say hi, Mom, on TV.
I hope is she watching.
She probably is, and if she's awake, hey, Mom, love you.
But
sorry about the dishes.
Whoops.
You didn't help with the dishes?
Well, no, Elmo wasn't there.
He wasn't there.
He didn't
but
help.
You will be. You're going to help me clean, right?
Oh, really?
Yes.
Okay.
Do you do a lot of chores on Sesame Street?
Well, Elmo tries to.
What do you do?
Well, Elmo guesses he's doing the dishes.
Yes, sweeping, you know, dishes,
sweeping,
whatever.
Sweeping dishes. Mm-hmm. Do you know what I love about you, Elmo, too? You sing a lot. Does that help you remember your ABCs and your numbers?
Oh, that's true. There's lots of songs that help you remember different numbers and letters.
Well, like what? Do you sing together?
Sometimes we do, but not today, right? Because, wait, are you... go for it.
One of Elmo's favorite songs is about the number 2.
It is? Mm-hmm. Well, how does it go?
Is my favorite number. Two is neat. Two is being together. How much time we got? Two is sweet.